What's the nuttiest thing you've ever done?
Me and my nana went to a restaurant. I had peas on my plate and I flicked one at this woman and it went down her top.
Nope! You nuttiest sunbat!
Yummy!
It's the nuttiest thing you've ever done!
Now you deign to arrive, Mr. Fiddler, we can begin.
Physically, I've reached my peak. From now on, I can only deteriorate.
I'm afraid it's spoilt now. thought your daddy was supposed to be a writer. He hasn't written much on here, Victoria. Melanie, manners.
Dear all, have ploughed the stormy seas.
Storms?
Very rough weather, good to be back on terra firma. However, the boat trip was wonderful. First class service all round. P.S. Be good chicks and lots of love, Mummy. Oh.
Are you finished with your pudding, dear?
Do you want the cart, Jonathan?
Wrong sort of boat. Almost as bad as an aeroplane.
They're going to fly everywhere. Mean things. They should have taken us.
We're too young.
I'm not too young. Juliet was my age.
Juliet who?
In the play. She was married by my age. And Mummy. Mummy wasn't much older than me when she got married. Well, not that much older.
Have you seen my shoe?
It's under the bed.
We need to get going. The train leaves in an hour.
Just think, Melanie. America. Isn't it exciting?
And we'll be back in autumn. You'll see. The summer will simply fly by. We will write to you.
Yes, every week.
Bye.
Bye, darlings.
Thank you.
We'll give Madam one last chance. Melanie? Victoria and I are going to the village. If you want any breakfast, you must get it yourself. And clear up after you. Loud. Melanie? Melanie? Families should stick together.
Well, your auntie and uncle will look after you.
We didn't even know Uncle Philip was married. Mummy never said. I don't think he liked Daddy very much. He never came to see us. Oh!
Here. For the train? Oh, come on. Melanie will look after you.
If they'd stayed on the boat, none of this would have happened.
They had to fly. There's no other way. You can't get from Chicago to New Orleans by boat.
Oh, yes, you can. I checked. By riverboat, down the River Illinois from Chicago to St. Louis, and then on the Mississippi.
The train now standing on Platform 6 is the 1147 from Cheltenham.
It'll be Miss Melanie.
Yes. I thought our uncle was going to meet us.
Well, get your bags.
He was called away suddenly on business and sent us in his place, even going so far as to give us the necessary taxi fare, an unaccustomed attack of generosity on his part.
Jonathan.
Oh, you'll need to know who we are. We're the brothers of his wife, which makes us, in an unsanctified kind of way, your uncles.
I see.
My name is Finn. My brother is called Francie.
But you're Irish. Well,
there's no law, as I know of, to prevent it.
As yet.
What's your name?
Didn't they tell you your Auntie Margaret was done?
We'll get your things upstairs. Settle you in.
Thanks. Isn't Uncle Philip back yet?
One thing at a time.
In daytime, you can see St. Paul's.
It's like a crow's nest in a ship.
Crow's nest?
Jonathan's hobby is sailing ships.
Oh, I see. Put your clothes here.
Oh, thanks. There's no mirror.
There's not.
Oh. Excuse me. I can manage.
Excuse me.
He's a pajama case, really.
Do you know, you've lovely hair. Even if you're tormented in those braids.
I like plaits.
You're spoiling your pretty looks. Come here.
Don't you ever wash your neck?
Thank you.
She ought to be in bed.
You're the early bird, after the late night you had. Curled up on the landing like love locked out.
I did like the music.
I carried you up to your bed. No, you must go and change your clothes now, this minute. He can't abide a woman in trousers. He says a woman in trousers is a sin against nature.
A sin against what?
Slip up and change into a skirt, else he'll create something terrible. Don't you want to make a good impression on your first day?
Is there anything else I should know about him?
speak when you're spoken to. He likes his women quiet.
Yes.
I see you've plaited your hair again.
I saw his teeth in the bathroom.
He can take out his smile and keep it on a shelf, but his bite is worse than his bark. Isn't that so, old fellow?
Mummy was scared of him, I think. He went to her wedding, but he was furious. You can see it in the photograph.
She got away.
He used to send us toys, but, well, Mummy burnt them because they were so frightening.
He made that in his off hours.
It's as though he trapped a real cuckoo inside.
Didn't you know he made things?
No.
He's forced to sell the toys to keep us all, but he keeps the other stuff to entertain himself. Come and see. I'm the sorcerer's apprentice in this establishment. I paint the feathers and the fur and the skin, but it's himself breathes the life in. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Flower's Marionette Microcosm. Don't fret. It's only his dream. Dreams aren't catching, not like measles.
I didn't know about the puppets. It's a lot to take in all at once. Go home.
Home is where the heart is.
But I can't. I can't go home because there's no home left.
Shift yourself, girly.
Improperly dressed, Finn.
Hello, I'm Melanie.
You're late for breakfast.
Sorry.
Right. This morning's plan of action is as follows. The big girl to stay with her auntie in the shop to learn the prices of things and where they're kept. Two. The child to stay with them and occupy herself whilst getting into as little trouble as possible. Three. The boy to do a bit of...
May I go and work on my boat, please?
That's plastic. You made it from a kit, not your own creation. Try harder. You come with me. Show him how a real craftsman works. Downstairs in 5 minutes.
He didn't even ask our names.
He knows your names.
She's not accustomed to being ignored.
She'll have to learn.
What about school?
It's too late in the year to start.
Come here, boy. Hey, come here. Have you seen one of these before?
No, sir.
Sir, is it? Mark that, Finn. Yeah. Here's a piece of wood, try it.
see. Wood's got life in it, not like plastic. Butterfingers. Wood's got life in it. Look. Fair price for my work. And you be careful with them things. Your bread and butter now. Did you do this?
Well, Victoria...
What? You let that child play with one of my toys? I don't like children playing with my toys. Give it a saucepan to play with, that'll do it. We'll have to fix you up with another hammer, won't we?
London would be like this.
A 100 years ago, the Queen of England threw a big party. And everyone who was still there at cockcrow turned to stone. Now she's the queen of the wasteland.
She's a fallen woman, poor thing.
away from me.
It's not in aid of you. You don't know the way home.
Edward Bear. Do you think he knows how to do it?
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome. Tonight we celebrate the grand opening of Flower's Marionette Microcosm. We present an original drama entitled An Artist's Passion. Thank you.
Hasn't the statue got any eyes?
Mm-hmm. The creator adds the last vital tints to his masterpiece. How can the artist transmit life to that which is his own creation and expresses the very depth of his being? The artist offers his creation, his heart, his hand, his very being. Each man kills the thing he loves.
Whoops.
Use him to work the puppets again. Or use you instead of a puppet, miss? Why shouldn't she earn a keep? God knows she eats enough. She's not too big. She won't be out of scale.
That's settled then.
You having a bite more to eat, Margaret? Watch it. Come on. Live with the Irish, live like pigs.
Excuse me.
Hey, more.
Bye, dear.
Bye.
Look what I made.
Show it in the window. Might fetch you a couple of quid.
I'm earning my keep, sir.
Not yet, you're not.
£10? Hmm? Really?
Uncle Philip wants Melanie downstairs straight away.
Well, can I keep my shoes on? I need my coat to go downstairs. It's freezing away from the fire.
Take that coat off. You're well built. How old are you?
16. Well, nearly 16.
I wanted my leader to be a little girl. Leader and the swan. See? Big swan, little leader. You're a big girl, ain't ya?
Do you have periods?
What's that to do with swans?
Keep your mouth shut, Finn. I'll talk to her how I please.
I can say what I like.
Oh, no, you can't. Get on with your painting.
It's all right, Finn.
I suppose you'll do. Turn round.
Smile. Not like that. Show your teeth. You got a bit of a look of your mother. None of your father, thank God. You should have seen his face when I turned up at the wedding. Thought I was going to drag her away with me. But I knew she was gone for good.
Yeah, you've got a fair bit of your mother in you, though.
Come on, walk up and down. You're not very graceful, are you? Hey, Finn. Teach you how to shift yourself. Always fancied yourself at the light fantastic, didn't you, eh? Come on, get on with it! Not down here, you've spoiled the set. Upstairs.
We brought them with us from over the sea.
Sorry.
That's your beach. This is the story. Leda walks by the shore, gathering shells. Night comes on. She hears the beating of great wings and sees the approach of the swan. She runs away, but it bears down and casts her to the ground. Curtain.
Is that all?
Ah. You should see the swan. His masterpiece. Now, walk along the beach and stoop to pick up the shell. That won't do. Make it flow. Try again. That's better. Now do it again. I'll be the swan. Swish. Swish. That's the beating of my wings. When you hear that, you put a spurt on. He'll turn you out if you don't do what he wants, Melanie. You run. You stumble. And I bear you to the ground with my enormous pinions.
Finn? Finn? There's a splinter in your left foot. Look, if you don't let me take the splinter out, it will fester.
Go away.
What did I do wrong?
I won't do it because he wants me to do it. Even if I want to do it.
Do what? Oh, I see.
You're only a young thing.
You're not so old yourself.
Living with him put years on me.
Wishful thinking. You never finished it.
That was wishful thinking, too.
There aren't any mirrors in the house.
Music! Get started!
Leader gathers shells by the shore in the approaching dusk. Little does she know that Almighty Jove has picked her out to be his mate. The sound of thunder announces the presence of the majestic visitant. Leader attempts to flee her heavenly suitor, but but his beauty and majesty bear her to the ground.
The innocent girl's thighs tremble. The loins melt. She falls.
Almighty Jove, in the form of a swan, wreaks his will.
I didn't like that play.
Who's there? The door's not locked.
Can I come into bed with you for a little while? I feel terrible.
Well, yes, all right, but...
Ah, come on now. Would you mind holding me in your arms for a little while?
Finn.
I'm cold.
You are cold. Where have you been?
I finished it off.
You did what?
I chopped it into little pieces.
Doesn't pick on Jonathan.
Can you move over a wee bit?
The swan was so ridiculous. All the same, it did scare me.
Almighty Jove in the shape of a swan.
Stop it.
I've got a present for you.
Finn.
In my pocket. It's a swan's egg.
do you mean? Run away to sea?
Well, Philip's gone and taken his teeth with him.
Reprieve.
Well, I know for a fact he didn't take Jonathan. Jonathan went off by himself.
I'm going to sit in his chair. Don't fret. It can't swallow me up. I am seized with a great and glorious notion. Let's make today a holiday. Himself being absent, and the swan destroyed.
He chopped it up.
I shifted it out there, on the bonfire. Tonight, it will burn.
You're mad, booger. He chopped it up.
Victoria, will you go and fetch me my silver necklace?
Somebody couldn't wait until dark.
Hmm?
Nothing. You shouldn't have given Victoria that Guinness.
It was only a mouthful.
Do you think we should take her up to bed?
Oh, yes. I think we should.
Kings and queens of Egypt.
Yes.
Well, I never encountered it before. Not in my family.
No.
She was fondest of you, because you're the youngest.
Did you know?
But surely she's older.
Only by 3 or 4 centuries.
Rain's making it hard for the fire to catch.
I don't see the guy. They haven't put the guy on the bonfire yet.
Shall you take all your clothes off now? And I'll finish off your portrait.
Careful! Mind the little girl.
Part with you, my treasure.
Kiss me before you go.
serve my time, and so did you.
Now, sir. Now, sir.
Who touched my sword?
My brother's fetching the guy.
Lost everything once.
So did I.
But then I had a brother and sister left.
So had I.
Everything's gone now.
Nothing is left but us.